I'm drinking tea in the studio. Yeah? For the first time, if you're watching on Kaya TV, hello, cheers to you. I've got tea on my table. Why? Because Miss Vogue is here. Manyana, dumela.
Dumela, ntate.
Okay.
Keteng.
Ha o motle.
Yo. Kyalebo.
And to hear that Thando is a prosecutor.
Was a prosecutor.
What do you mean was? Are you, was. Have you let go of that world completely?
Yo, actually, I think I left in 2016. I took my sabbatical, which turned into a very long sabbatical.
Yeah.
But yes, I was a prosecutor for 4 years.
Where?
I was working for the National Prosecuting Authority, go maybe the Westgate Court.
Okay.
That was the very popular court, Johannesburg Match Court, Le JP Magistrate Court.
Yeah.
And then I went back to Westgate to specialize in sexual offense cases.
Oh my word.
I know, it's quite a journey.
And do we know any of the famous cases that you've dealt with?
I think I did it for 2 years, sexual offences, so I was not really kind of at advocate level, Wukherinel type. No.
Oh my word, so now you went into law.
Yes.
Was that always the plan? Was that always the passion?
So my father actually wanted me to be an accountant.
Oh.
And I wanted to be an actress. So we had a difference in philosophy and we both agreed on law.
Oh, okay.
And that's actually how I went into the law degree. But when I went into prosecuting, I had started doing community-centered law.
Yes.
It's a thing called street law, koskolong, govets.
Yeah.
And then I decided I want to do community-centered law, and that's how I went into prosecuting.
So you studied this at Wits?
Yes.
Take me back to Lens. But I'm told there was a life before Lenasia, right?
No, well, I was very small before Lenasia. I can't really remember much of that life, yeah.
Okay, take me to Lens.
To Lens, okay. So I grew up in Lens for most of my life, and it was quite a mixed community.
Yeah.
So it was Indian, black, colored. So that's where I kind of started most of my childhood.
Yeah. Mm. And here you are in a mixed environment, but you still felt different.
I was the only not pigmented person there. because it was like an Indian community, black community, but everywhere I went,
yes.
I was the only one who looked the way I did, you know.
Yes,
I even looked different from my parents, really.
Yeah.
But I think nako kele munyane nexai boninto, and I never really saw difference until you kind of start going to school or other places where people are like, wait a minute, you're different, and you're like, wait a minute, I am. You didn't know all this time.
Yeah.
So, yeah, because, I mean, I remember the first time I went to school, it was such a strange thing because, I mean, I'm home. When I was at home, I was this princess and, you know.
Sure.
How fit like was kolong, and then they're like, no, but you are this, you know, when people start calling you names and stuff like that, you're like.
You're giving these labels. But
exactly.
And then when you get back home?
You know, I think I remember because when I went to school my first time, I actually was wearing my mother didn't put school uniform on me, or like a blue polka dot dress.
Okay.
So when I got treated differently koskolong by the other kids, I thought it was because of the dress. So I went to her demanding the school uniform, and she was just like, oh, and then... You know,
yeah.
But because I didn't see myself as different, so I thought it was the dress that was a problem.
Yes.
And eventually, I mean, I got back and I got the school uniform and everything, and still there was a funniness, koskolo, you know.
Yeah.
And I didn't really open up to my parents until much later. Where there's this problem because I didn't understand what was happening.
Yeah. Couldn't they tell? Couldn't they sense?
You know,
when you were home.
You know, I think my mother was just trying to do is she was trying to do her part in saying, we love you, you are enough. But she was like, I'm gonna let you figure this out. And I think it was probably a very difficult decision for her.
I'm listening to you and I feel there's just so much more. There's a layer to you. Layers. To
I'm an
you.
Onion.
Oh yeah. And I don't know how you're gonna peel them, but I'm gonna be looking, watching, with eager and as a fan, as a fellow countryman, as a brother, and I'm hoping to see those layers come through and through and through,
thank
and forever
you.
And a day.
Thank you.
Thank you for being who you are and thank you for how you were raised and for you fighting to be and finding your space in the world, because who knows, maybe today would have never happened for you to open our eyes to the world that is, to open our eyes to the diversity that is nature. You know?
Thank you.
and for that, I just want to say, I love it, I embrace it, and I'm challenged, and hopefully from today on, I'm even growing, not only as a parent, but as a human being. So take on the world, and through you, we will shine.
Gale wanted. Thank you.
That is Thando Hopa, guys. Nagia, hi, I'm done.